गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन इन योर ऑनलाइन बायोलॉजी क्लास। योर गोपाल श्रीवास्तव, आई एम टेकिंग योर बायोलॉजी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द कंटिन्यूस टॉपिक ऑफ द एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस आई हैव कंप्लीटेड द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन द ह्यूमन बींग, sexual reproduction in human being, where the two parents are required, where the two parents and their gametes are required for the fertilization. After fertilization, zygote is formed. After formation of zygote, there are so many different division or differentiation are formed. After that, a embryo, a fetus convert into the child. The day of pregnancy, from the first day of the menstrual flow until the birth, this is called the gestation, or this is called the pregnancy period. After the 280 days, a baby born from the female human beings, or you can say the after 40 week or 280 days. Okay, now today I will explain the some questions which are given on the basis of the topic of the sexual reproduction. So all of you open the page number 142, and there fifth question are they given in the your oral questions. So write down the answer with the help of pencil in the book. Don't write anywhere. Write down in the diary book, very small answer. So all of you ready, and let's start to write down the answer of the oral question of the page number 142. Class 8, subject science, sub subject biology. Okay. Topic oral questions of page number 142. It take only few minutes, then I will start the asexual reproduction in the organism. I am also taking the book for the explanation of the question answer. Name the gamete produced by the male and female human being.
Answer: first, male produce sperm and female produced ova.
Second, name the process of fusion of egg and sperm. The fusion of male and female gamete is called fertilization.
So you will write down the fertilization. Third,
name the reproductive organs of the human female which receive the ovum and holds the developing fetus. Okay? Name the reproductive organs in the females which receive the ovum and hold the developing fetus, that is uterus.
U-T-E-R-U-S.
Uterus. And last, no, fourth, what are the animals which give birth to young ones called? What are the animals? You know, there are two types of animals, viviparous, oviparous. Viviparous giving the birth of the child. So this is called viviparous. V-I-V-I-P-A-R-O-U-S.
And fifth, how does a malarial parasite reproduce? Student, write down multiple
fission.
Due to by?
Multiple
fission. Complete your student. Now, there are two ways by which the young ones born. That is oviparous, means egg-laying animals, and viviparous, giving birth of the young ones. Now, giving the birth of the organism, how young ones change to the adult. So student, the next topic of your book, that is the young one to adult. Young ones to adult. Young ones to adult. Student, various organs are and their childs and their adult. So the structure of the young ones and the adult are very differences in between them. For example, the larva of the silkworm is very different to their adults. And in the frog, the tadpole is so very different from their adults. In your book, there are two life cycles are given after the giving birth of the young ones. So there is the life cycle of silkworm and life cycle of a frog given. Okay? After the mating, the silkworm give the laying eggs. After the many moultings, from laying the eggs, after 10 to 12 days, hatching is start. Hatching is they break down from their eggs and come out. Okay, this is called a hatching. Then they molting, means shed out their old skin and wear their new skin. This is called molting. Okay. Then it converted into the cocoon. Inside their cocoon, they molt once again. Okay. And emergence means break down the cocoons and come out the larva into the from the cocoons. This is the life cycle of the silkworm. And the frog. Frogs are generally lays the egg in the on the water, surface of the water. Okay, so there are so many changes are found from larva to the adult. Okay, suppose this is the frog. They give eggs. Okay? they give the eggs.
This is a fertilized eggs. Spawn.
Okay. Now the egg converted to the 2-3 days old.
After 2-3 days old, converted into the
tadpole type. Tadpole.
Tadpole. Tadpole
six days
old tadpole. Now
now this is the stage. This is tadpole stage. Tadpole stage. 12 week old. 12 week old. Tadpole. 16 weeks. 16 weeks. So after 12 week, the tail is disappeared from their body. But the first stage, they are look like this. Small fish, they have tail and very small forelimb. After the molting of the metamorphosis of the 6 days, the tail reduces in their sizes and they are big, so large in the 2 and 3 days old tadpoles. Then after few days, few week, they again metamorphosis, means molting. And they reduce their
tails and the hind limbs also generated from their body. And after few days they are grow well. In the 16 weeks that they have well developed fore limbs and hind limbs. And the tail is totally disappeared from their body and an adult frog is formed. So this is the life cycle of the frog. So you can look, the young ones of the frog is so very different from the adult. So the young ones to the adult, same the process in the silkworm also. Same process in the silkworm also. Okay, you can draw this. Now, student, there are so many ways are found in the asexual reproduction. So, I am giving the explanation about the asexual reproduction in different animals. In asexual reproduction, only one parent organism required. Only one parents, not two. One parent is required, and they give the birth to the identical in their size, same as the parents. There are so many ways. In your book, so many ways. Fission, and budding are only given in your book. But except this, fragmentation, regeneration, spore formation, vegetative propagation, tissue culture, and so many others. Ways by which the new organism can grow from their one parent cell. Okay? There are so many methods by binary fission. By binary fission. It is found generally in the amoeba. You know, amoeba have the irregular size. This is cytoplasm, this is the nucleus, and this is cytoplasm. First, the amoeba, their nucleus are enlarged in two, in their size, elongated. And after that, their body part also divided into two parts. And two parts. And the nucleus divided into the, this is the cytoplasm also divided into two daughter nuclei and form the two daughter AMOEBE amoeba. This is a binary fission. And multiple fission, second is the multiple fission.
So student, in the binary fission, first nucleus divided into two parts, then cytoplasm divided into two parts. Okay, then stretching leads, this stretching leads to formation of two daughter nuclei. Okay, this is the formation of the new individual of the amoeba. And in the binary, in the multiple fission, it is found in the
malarial parasite.
You know, malarial parasite is a protozoan. It is found in the cyst,
cyst.
Inside the cyst, you know, this is the cell. Okay,
cell.
Inside the cyst, they are multiplied into many nucleus. Inside the cyst. Okay. So, a cyst or a protective coating form around the cell. Cyst is a protective cover which is around the, found around the cell. Inside the cyst, cell multiple divide to form many cells. Form many cells. This cyst they have broken and released so many cells. Okay, so many daughter cells.
Many DAUGH. Many daughter cells are released from one cell.
Okay, now
third, this is second, budding. You know, this is a hydra. Suppose this is a hydra. Okay, this is parent hydra. This is tentacles, A-M-T-A-C-L-E-S, tentacles.
A outgrowth buds are a buds, like progesterone form on the body of the organism, that is called bud. Means the ball-like structure. The projection, bulb-like projection, this is called a bud. This is called a bud. Bulb-like projection form. In the bud, after some time,
this bulb grow in their size, in their parent cell, and form so many tentacles in the bud.
Okay, so when they are get matured, when the buds get matured, they detach, detached,
detached from the parent body. Okay, from the parent body. Suppose they detach from the parent body and form the new individual.
Okay, on detached form a new hydra,
form a new hydra.
So this types are the forming of a new individual from the parent cell is called the budding. It's called a budding. Now a cloning. Cloning means the formation of the new individual from the one parent cell in identical same. This is called cloning. means the formation of exact copy of the parent cell from any body part of the organism is called cloning. In your book, a female dorset and a black fish, they are two examples. Okay? They are generally grow outside of the female body, then it transplanted into the female uterus. After few days, a new baby is born. In this system, the scientist take the one cell from the female and one cell from the male, and they fertilize on the test tube. After successfully fertilization, a zygote is formed. This zygote is transplanted into the uterus of the female. Okay. So this stage of the formation of a new individual is called cloning. Okay. Now there are some questions are given in the page number. I am also taking the book for the explanation of the question. Oral question on the page number 145. Oral question. Page number 145. Open. Write down with the help of pencil. Name two organisms which reproduce by asexual method. First, Hydra. Second, LMOE amoeba. Hydra and amoeba. Second, name two methods of asexual reproduction. Two methods. First is the binary fission. Second is the budding. Third, name the method by which amoeba reproduce. By binary fission amoeba reproduce. By what name are the animals which lay eggs called? By what name? Oviparous. Fifth, what is the transformation of the larva into an adult silkworm is called? Metamorphosis. It's called metamorphosis. Metamorphosis. Write down, student, write down homework. Read asexual method. Asexual reproduction. Read asexual reproduction in animals. Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Write down all in the book with the help of pencil. And student, you can also write the very short question answer of this chapter in your fear. The answer already given in the back side of your book. Very short. So all of you completed the very short question answer in your copy. Thank you. Class is over.